Good morning, everyone. I'm Dr. Preeti Sharda, librarian of Postgraduate Government College for Girls, Sector 42, City, Chandigarh. I welcome you all to this one-day webinar on improving communication skills by using Cambridge University app. This is the fourth webinar in the row. I strongly believe that being able to communicate effectively is perhaps the most important. Friends, I strongly believe that being able to communicate effectively is perhaps the most important of all life skills. It enables us to pass information to other people and to understand what is said to us. The webinar is being curated to create awareness about Cambridge University app, which is presently free to use. This app can help us to improve our communication skills efficiently and effectively. Dear participants and dear students, let me tell you something about our college, which is a premium multi-faculty institution of higher education in the city beautiful Chandigarh. It was established in 1982, spread over a spacious campus of nearly 18 acres in the southern part of Chandigarh. The college has emerged as an all-encompassing institute. The college has been accredited Grade A by NAC. A team of 119 dedicated and highly qualified faculty members, high-tech library, well-equipped laboratories, smart classroom, premium sport equipment facilities facilitate effectual teaching and contribute in shaping the next generation. Now let me introduce you to our principal, Madam Professor Nisha Agarwal. Professor Nisha Agarwal has recently joined as principal of our college. She is a former principal of Government College of Commerce and Business Administration, Chandigarh. She has a strong experience of handling college administration and financial duties as a HOD of Commerce at colleges like PGD CG 11 and PGD CG 42. She has an excellent teaching experience of about 35 years and has ability to train teachers to do their best. She's an expert in preparing effective college curriculum and managing student relations. Professor Agarwal has co-authored a number of books on subjects like financial markets and institution, financial services, and etc. She has published many research papers in refereed journals and presented papers in many national and international conferences. She possesses super communication skill and interpersonal skills. Now I invite Principal Madam to formally inaugurate the webinar and say a few words of wisdom. Over to you, Madam.
It is a matter of extreme joy to welcome all the participants to this session. In communication skills with Cambridge universities are always important to stay abreast of latest development on the field. It gives us a chance to benefit from the vast experience of the speaker. Communication is a fine art that we all. It takes more than physical and verbal abilities. Communication. Personal success depends on our ability to communicate effective human relations and on our communication skills. Overall, interpersonal communication skills are necessary for understanding and action. Looking at the importance of communication, Postgraduate Government College for Girls 42 Chandigarh organized this webinar in collaboration with Cambridge University Press today. This workshop will explore the importance of and techniques necessary for successful interactions. There will be demo of a free app by University Press, through which communication can be learned easily. On behalf of PG Government College for Girls, Sector 42, Chandigarh, I would like to thank Cambridge University Press in supporting us in organizing this webinar, which I'm sure would be full of learning. I would request all the participants to be attentive throughout the session and use all the learnings from this session in their lives. So, without any further delay, let us begin today's session.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am, for your encouraging words and giving Cambridge University Press this opportunity to be part of this webinar. And I'm also sure under your leadership, the college will definitely reach newer heights. I welcome all students to today's session on improving communication skills with Cambridge Communication App. The session will be taken by my colleague, Richa Bhatla. Cambridge University has always been a front runner in helping learners build brighter futures. And we are excited to be a part of this session, which is being hosted by Postgraduate Government Girls College, Sector 42, Chandigarh. I also thanks once again Dr. Preeti Sharda for giving us this opportunity. I can assure you the session will be really insightful for all the students, as Richa has a vast experience in helping learners in owning their English skills. She's been an academician in her past stint and as a teacher and a professor. So definitely you're going to learn lot many things from this session. The session also has a Q&A. It has a Q&A round also. You can post all your questions in the Q&A chat box, and we will be happy to answer the same. Thank you, and over to you, Richa. Richa, you're on mute. Richa, you're on mute.
Hello, everybody. A very good morning to you. Thank you, Vineet. Thank you, Nisha ma'am, and thank you, Preeti ma'am, for organizing this amazing session to interact with lovely people, lovely girls, youth of the country of Sector 42 Chandigarh. It is our pleasure as a part of Cambridge team to interact with you. And I must start this session with a huge round of applause for all of you. And since this is a webinar, we cannot interact face to face, but through the all kudos to technology that even then we are able to interact. And you must be wondering that why I was saying for a kudos or a clap for everybody, because of the responsiveness. See, we spread this message with help of Nisha ma'am and Preeti ma'am to all the students of Chandigarh, Sector 42 Chandigarh, Government Girls College. And we could see the response, you know, there are around 502 participants. Vineet, Samarth, and Preeti ma'am, and if Nisha ma'am is also there, to just give a huge round of applause for the lovely audience. We can just unmute ourselves for a while, and we can just open up the camera if we can do that, and this is an amazing response. So dear audience, you know, the effort becomes more generous, and we feel eager as organizers. We feel more responsible when we see the response of you people, that every initiative that the college takes for a student, it becomes worthwhile. The efforts become worthwhile because of your responsiveness. So I would really try my level best to make this session super exciting for you, very interactive for you, so that we both, I could learn something from you today and you could learn something from me today, and that's how we would grow together. So dear students, as you would be knowing that why are we organizing this session? What is the purpose of this session? Most of you would already be knowing about it. So this, the objective is very same as you could read in the brochure, the material that was available to you by Cambridge University Press India, that this session is specifically to improve your communication skills. Now, there could be a question that how many of you really want to improve your communication skill? So we would be doing a short poll right now to initiate the session. And basis the polling, we will interact more. So I would request my teammate, Mr. Samarth Singh, to help us out with polling. The first question which I really want to understand from audience side is to know their screen, is to know your specialization. Like, are you from commerce, management, science, computers, humanities? What is your subject? So, Samad, may I request you to please flash on the first question for poll? Yes. So, this is the question to you, dear audience. Please choose your stream. Take your seconds. Be quick. Be responsive. We are really liking your response. And the attendance is also growing. It is 527 at this moment. So happy to see the audience. Great. We'll give you 5 seconds more. Okay, so countdown and then we'll end up the polling. It's 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So let's end the polling and let's see the score. Now we'll just see the results like, okay. So with us, we have mix of students. They are majorly from science and humanities and some from commerce. So we have around 37% students from science today, 36% students from humanities, and 24% from commerce, 4% are from other courses. Okay, that's a great response. So now I can see my audience from different streams. Awesome. So let us go to the next question. The next question is regarding, do you really want to be an effective communicator? Do you really feel that whatever is your stream, whatever stream you have chosen, whatever career you're dreaming for, whatever jobs you're dreaming for, do you think it is important to be a good speaker or a communicator? Though the response is flashing right in front of my eyes, but I would like to wait for more participants to answer the question. And by the way, the attendance is 545. Awesome. Four 50 people have responded. Great. We are waiting for more responses. You are the most active participants I have ever interacted in my life. Because of the participation, because of your attendance, it seems that you are really very responsive for such courses. Awesome. We have reached around 480 people have responded out of 544. More 60 students who are waiting to respond. We are waiting for you. Another 2-3 minutes we'll give you to just respond. Your responses are really precious for us. Wonderful. So we have around 493 people responded. And we'll just count on for 5 more seconds and then I'll share the score with you. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Thank you. So we have 495 people who responded to the question, and out of which there is 1% who says that communication is not that very important. Being a good speaker is okay, it's not very important. But majority, 492 people today in the audience says that 100% they agree that yes, being an effective communicator, being a good speaker is really very important. Good to see the score. Thank you so much for your responses. Now we have another question for you. So you would be wondering, is it a quiz going on that we are participating today and ma'am is just asking questions and questions? The reason that I am asking you questions is to know you better so that we are able to understand and give you the right thing. You are investing your precious 1 hour with us. So we want to make this 1 hour really fruitful for you for your entire life. So the next question, please. We are going to have next question for you. And the next question says that, in what aspects of your daily lives do you feel being a good speaker is useful? Is it like when you talk to your teachers and principal? Or when you talk to your seniors or peers, like you are now in the college and you would be interacting with everybody, your seniors, your classmates, Where do you feel the hurdle? Is it like participating in debates is a problem? You cannot go for any speaking competition or maybe for a writing competition because you feel that English is a problem for you. Is this is a problem? Or you also feel that you know so many things, but when it comes to writing your exams in English language, then the ideas don't come out because of the language problem. So we would like to know your responses here. You can give multiple answers to this question. That means you could choose as many options that you feel is a problem for you. And we are waiting for responses. Please take your seconds, think about it, where the major problem lies, and then we would have a solution for you. Yes, one more minute for you. Great, keep responding. This is very important suggestion that we would receive from you. Once we know the problem area, then only we can work together to make it better. Wonderful. So 505 students have responded so far, and there are 562 participants. Awesome. Such a lovely audience. And the another thing that it shows is a curiosity to learn. Being girls of all, like I being a girl, seeing my lovely audience as girls, the zeal to learn, the zeal to be better, the zeal to compete. Kudos to you. Well done, girls. And this is the beginning of the new year for you. I believe the entire year is going to be so rocking for you that you would try learning new things, try discovering what you really want in your life. And this is an amazing thing. We have got 523 responses. And now let's go back to the scores. Let us see the results. Awesome. So when we see the results, what do we discover? We see that major problem which the student face today is because of their speaking skills. They are not able to participate in the activities. Many times, you see, when we were in schools and you have freshly passed out from school, there are so many activities in the calendar in a school. And so it happens in the college as well. Every year you would see there are so many activities happening. But the problem is, do I participate in this activity? The question that we ask ourselves, the question that I used to ask myself when I was in college, do I participate in this activity? And majorly we step back because we feel that we are not smart enough to participate in debate. We are not smart enough to represent our house, our school, our college. In a house, I mean that we used to have the red, green, blue houses. Every school has that thing. So that is the reason that we don't participate. And we see today 79% of the audience face this problem. So that means we would definitely note down the score, and this score is not only important for Cambridge, it is equally important for college to know where the problem is. So we have 409 students who say that debate, elocution, group discussion is a major problem for us. Then we have 42% students who really want to come close to their teachers, close to the principal, share what's going on in life, what's going on in life. But the only problem that they face is my principal only talks to me in English. This used to happen with me, so I can relate well. I was not an effective speaker, and I really wanted to reach out to my principal to just share what's happening in college, what's happening in school. But because of the lack of communication skills, poor communication skills, I could not reach out to her and even close to my teacher. So even 42% population today, around 217 people say today that I'm not able to reach out to my teachers and principals because I am not an effective speaker. That is also one very important feedback that you have given to us. And then we have around 179% of the students who don't feel confident because they feel that they don't speak well. So they are not able to speak, make new friends. They're not able to speak well with their seniors from whom they can learn a lot. And around 140 students says, like 27% students says that they are not able to write well in exam. All these four feedbacks are very important. So dear students, you know, We all want to be better. We all want to grow in life. We all want to work on our weaknesses. So how can we improve those things where we lack? First thing is to identify. This particular question which you have answered has helped us identify the problem area. Where is the problem? And the major problem area that we could see today is coming on speaking, because in a daily life, you communicate to so many people. So speaking is a problem. How can I be an effective speaker? And we have a solution for you. Today, when we would conclude this session, you will definitely learn something that would really help you. And that secret I will tell you in a little while. So now we would ask you one last question, and then we will give you some tips to be an effective communicator. So the last question that we want to ask, Samar, please help me out in sharing the next question. Yeah. So the next question is, what are the benefits of having good English communication skill? So it says that, okay, being a good speaker is a problem today, but what is the benefit? Why do you want to learn English? Why do you want to be a good speaker? Where is it going to help you out? Why do you want to work in your problem area? In the previous question, we identified the problem, and now we are reasoning, why do we need to work in that problem area to be better? So how English is going to help you, how English communication skill is going to help you, there are various options given to you. You have choices to make, and please excuse me for having coffee to speak better in front of you. Yeah. So yes. We have got around 506 responses. We are waiting for more. There are 589 participants. Preeti ma'am would be super excited. I'm sure Nisha ma'am as well. I am so excited. Vineet and Samarth are equally excited because the session, this is the maximum strength and the maximum conversion so far, where we have seen like 90% and more students are coming to the message that we spread. Kudos to your hard work, ma'am. Your communication, your coordination was flawless, so that the responses are amazing. 550 people have responded out of 590 students here. Okay, so 5 more seconds. I'll just count down for you and then we would come out the results. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. So here we finish up this polling and let's come to the score. So as we see here, we asked you, why do you want to be a good speaker? In the previous question, we identified the problem. In this, we are reasoning you that anytime, whenever we want to do something, there is a reason behind it. So here the reason is, first of all, majority of us want to have a groomed personality. We want the overall personality development. That is the reason I want to be a better speaker in English language, which is a very good response. If I am in your shoes and I have to see what would I choose, I think personality was a very important criteria for me when I was in college. Then second thing which people have picked up is increased confidence, which is again a valid point. When we are an effective speaker, our confidence level increases. And that is how, when you speak well, when you're able to conversate well with the people, you are included in the group. You feel inclusive in all the surrounding because you have a way to share your thoughts. And that is how 65% of the population says that this will help me improving my confidence. Then we come back to the third point, which says the better job opportunities. Yes, being an effective speaker, especially in English, is the global requirement today. The reason that we asked about the streams, that are you from commerce, from management, from science, is to understand that what kind of job opportunities would you be seeing in future? Basis your stream, basis your interest area, every particular job requires a good communicator today. there would be people who would be dealing with the audience on a daily basis. Like today, I work for Cambridge and I am working for Cambridge and representing my organization in a platform. So we are frontline people. Now there are backline people or backend people who communicate with each other to make the things possible, which means like what Samarth is helping me out today. He is helping me out in coordinating the event. There would be 10 other people who would be helping him so that today's performance go best. So likewise, whatever is your department, whether you are frontline, whether you are back-end work in any discipline, you want to be a doctor, engineer, lawyer, businessman, professional, marketing, every job opportunity today requires English speaking because we work for multinational organizations, because the Indian organization works globally. So that is how we see the response. And the score is 47%. This particular feedback is so important for us as Cambridge, and I would request Vineet to make a note of it, and also as college heads, Swarnisha ma'am and Preeti ma'am, that the audience is pushing on personality development even more than the job opportunities, which shows that today, as Richa Batla, I want to be the best person. When Richa is best as an individual, she would be a good performer at the job place also. So the vision of the student is very clear. They want to be better speaker for their own personality development as criteria number one. And they believe when their overall personality is great, it is easy to get the job. It's such a thoughtful thing from their end. And then there are students who share that, yes, if I'm a good speaker, I would be able to communicate better with my people. I would be able to participate more and write well in exam. So the summary is, when your overall personality is refined, you can do wonders, whether it is your college, whether it is your job, whether it is your home, whether it is your friend circle, anywhere. So now this has helped us out that you are really aspiring to be a better communicator. I am so happy that I am talking to the audience. I'm talking to those young girls who have dreams. All of you have dreams in your eyes. And this is something very special, you know. This is a special thing that today girls are going everywhere. They're leading the world. They're leading the nation. They are letting the nation grow and they lead the family also. So being girls, you are doing a tremendous job and keep the spirit high. Today, I have learned from you, what do you want? Now, I want to offer you. I want to offer you something which would really help you uplifting your career and be a better speaker in English language. If we talk about in general, so I would tell you a few tips. Like if we talk about in general that, why do I want to be an effective speaker? We have got the responses. Now, if I ask you, I will be, before showing you something, I want to ask you one thing. What do you do on a daily basis to improve your communication skill? We have learned about English is important. We have learned about why English is important. Now we want to know that what are you doing at present to be an effective communicator? This is an open question. There is no option available to you. There is a chat box. Now there is a chat box where you can reply. You can write what do you do. It is okay if you're not doing anything at present, but you are dreaming to do. Every day you say that I want to be a better speaker. I want to start speaking in English. I want to do something. So whatever you want to do, but you're not able to do due to any reason, what you really want to do, just write it. We would like to hear and see the responses from you. So some say we read books, some say we watch videos, some say we speak with other people, some are saying we are reading journals, and there are so many responses. Keep writing. 500 plus audiences responding to every message, so I believe I'm getting 500 replies. It would be really difficult for me to complete 500 replies in a short while, but the maximum I could do, I will definitely do. So we could see the repetition is majorly on reading, wonderful, and videos, that we have watched so many videos. They talk to each other, they use dictionary, they use Hollywood, they use subtitles, and these are, see, when I'm opening up, I'm sharing, It is not like I'm sharing it for myself. I could read it silently. I am sharing so that you could learn from each other. You could take some ideas. Oof, I could have also read. I could have also watched the video. I could have also read some subtitles and improved my English. So we are just sharing the ideas. Keep learning from each other. Newspaper. Okay. So, all right. So I keep writing. Okay. 5 more seconds for this. And I will speak out when I see some different answer because it is repeatedly the same thing. I used to speak English, all right. And awesome. Meanwhile, students who are writing the answer, you please write. The students who have already written the answer, please use Q&A section for any question that you want to ask where you feel there's a problem while you are learning English. Please put your questions in Q&A section of the platform and we would be happy to address those questions in another 5 to 10 minutes once I show you the surprise. So we read. Okay. All right. So as we can see, majority of the students have written answers which are related to that on a daily basis they read. Yes, reading really helps us to be a better speaker also. Reading gives us good words. Reading helps us in improving vocabulary. And just not English, reading gives you a lot of knowledge. You are able to live the life of so many authors when you read his or her book. Like if I talk about recent example, when I was reading Abdul Kalam, I was thinking about his life journey, that what all struggles he had gone through. When I'm reading Steve Jobs, I could think about his childhood, that what Steve Jobs used to wonder when he was a kid. So that means, you know, when you read about other people, you get to know so much and it really helps you improving your knowledge as well. It helps you with being effective communicator. Now, the people have talked about videos. Yes, video also helps you a lot. Watching to English movies, watching English songs, starting with subtitles. When you see on the screen, there is a subtitle written. It will really help you to pick up the right words, speak them well. There is a voice modulation. There is a correct pronunciation. So this is also a very good idea. Some says that they make notes of the new words. This I still do till this time. I started this practice when I finished my class 12, exactly the age that you are in today. I had a notebook. I used to write 5 words daily, anywhere from my surrounding. It could be newspaper, it could be any book I am reading, it could be any magazine lying on the table. I would just pick up the magazine, find out 5 words and write it out. So this practice really helps you. Today, I might be having around 6,000 words with me, but I don't remember 6,000 words. I might be just remembering 60 words or 100 words. But if I wouldn't have done the journey of 6,000 words, I wouldn't have remembered those 60 or 100 words. So the importance is to do. Important is to practice. And your daily basis practice will really help you improve your English on a daily basis. People say that we talk to the environment. People say that we are talking to our friends to be effective communicator. Yes, this is very important. Be it a right English or wrong English, it doesn't matter. Don't worry about the judgments of the other person that this person is speaking completely wrong. A person of wisdom will always appreciate you that you are making an effort. That is why, you know, we feel good talking to our teachers. Why? Because teacher always appreciate the initiative. I am glad this child even tried. So that's what I'm telling you, that it is the best way. Whatever you learn, share with others. Whatever you are learning, be it any new word, a new sentence, practice it. The more you will practice with the people who give you a friendly environment first, then you would be able to feel comfortable speaking it anywhere. And that's how we all start. That's how I started. That's how anybody starts. So yes, now there are one more way. There is another way how you can improve your communication skill. And that is what I want to show it to you today. For for this, I would just request you to give me a few seconds to open up and share my screen with you. And then I will share with you what exactly I have. So Samarth, my screen is visible?
Yes, it is.
Great. So dear audience, what I really wanted to show you today is the newly launched Cambridge Communication app. This app is absolutely free for you, and the people who are present today in the session, they are the people who are knowing about this app on the first go. To know about this app, what is this app, how it is going to help you out, I would request you, all 591 students present today, to just download the app on your phone while the session is going on. You would go to Play Store. There's a link given there in the chat box. Samarth will share the link again with you just now. And he will share the link with you. You will click on the link. You will go to your Play Store and download the app. Meanwhile, the app is getting downloaded. You keep listening to me and just know what this app is all about. So link is shared, Samarth?
Yeah, it's shared.
Awesome. So link is shared. The students who could do the two jobs together of listening to me and going to the app, please do it. Those who feel this is a problem, I cannot do two jobs again to listen to ma'am and listen and go to the thing. You can take your good time. Once we finish up the session, you can just quickly go and download it. This is for a limited time period. This is not free for the lifetime. It is available to you only for another till 15th of October. And we would really request if it could do more on it. But as of today, this app is absolutely free until 15th October. So you have time with you. You have almost 10 days and more than 10 days. No, it's 10 days. Yeah. You just have 10 days with you to learn maximum from this app. If you would really learn and get benefit out of it, we would be able to discover more such things for you that would really help you. So while you're downloading the app from the Play Store by the link given to you on the chat box, I will take you to the tour of this app, which is really exciting. The name of the app is Cambridge Communication App, and the logo is the way it has appeared on the screen with the two dialogue boxes. This app will teach you about business English and general English. In business English, it doesn't mean that you have to do any business to learn business English. Business English can be learned by anyone who is in any official setup. When I say official setup, it doesn't mean only office. It could be your study place also. Like means that you are now studying in a college. This college is an official setup. You cannot be in college as it is the way you are at home. There is a certain way of dressing up, certain way of communicating, certain way of expressing and learning. There is a formal way of a learning environment where you try to learn maximum following the certain protocols. So this is what business English will teach you. Now in business English, you would learn about how to write better mails, how to communicate with your peers in a much effective manner, how to speak to your teachers effectively, and not only it will be just confined to your college environment. Once you go to the job area, once you interact with your colleagues, once you interact with the directors of the organization, how would you interact with them? How would you keep your point that, sir, I am right over here. Could you please try to understand my point? So the gesture, the politeness, the way is all taught in business English. And when we talk about general English, it is in general. We talk generally at home. We go out and meet our friends. We talk to strangers. We go to gym. We go for shopping. We do so many jobs in a day or especially the weekend. So we could learn about the general English skills through this app also. Now, when we talk about the levels, there are three levels in the app, which is foundation, basic, and intermediate, which means to learn from the scratch, go for the foundation level. to go from a middle, somewhere you feel that you don't need to start from scratch, you can choose a basic, and somebody who is really very fluent can go for the intermediate level. Both the levels, both three levels are available in business English and general English. If I tell you my story, I started from foundation. And when I was at your age, foundation, there was no app like this. App just came a month before. When I started learning this app, okay, I want to learn more. So I started with foundation because there are many tips that you learn even from the level, which is the lowest level here, but it will teach you many things which you might be missing out till now. And that is how we have 75 units for business English and 75 units for general English. And then it also has a test series. That means once you are done with the unit, you will go to the test, assess your skills, how much have you learned, and then be better, learn from your mistakes. So this is how the screen looks like. Once you will download the app, most of you would have already downloaded the app. I would like you to just take a tour of the app on your own. Open up the app, go to the unit, pick up the unit, start seeing a few sessions, maybe if you can. So by the end of the session, which is going to end in another 15, 20 minutes or maximum 30 minutes, if we would take more questions from you, then I would like to take your feedback also. I would love to take your feedback that how did you find the app? So be spontaneous in doing the app journey. So as we see the dashboard, there's a foundation level, there's a basic level, and there's an intermediate level. And it seems to be there are a lot of pictures to create interest. It is not going to be a yawning session for you. I hope you are not yawning right now. And it is very exciting and interesting and catchy so that you pick up the topic of your choice and learn more. So when we pick up any topic, here we have picked up meeting and greeting people. This is how the screen would look like. Topic is mentioned, meeting and greeting people, and beneath that we see meeting and greeting people test. So once you finish up your unit, you can go to the test. You can even take a break in between. There is no time foundation that you have to just give the test quickly. You can take 2 days, 3 days, as much, but you know, procrastination is never a solution. If you really want to improve, you have to be fast. You have to not delay. You have to make it a part of your calendar that every day, 15 minutes to improve my English, I would love to give. The spirit should be there. If the spirit is there, if the effort is there, nobody can stop you to be the best communicator in the world. I'll just show you how the app looks like for the students who are just watching the session. Those who have already gone to the app, they would have seen the dialog box coming up. So this is how it appears. When you will choose the topic, like the way we have chosen meeting and greeting people, it says, hello, welcome to the unit. You would say, thanks. And now we see some audio coming in the screen. That means when you will be playing this audio, it would be sharing some information with you. And then it is also asking you a question. Then you are responding. It is saying, correct. There is something else coming up. And again, there's a picture. Okay. Then again, there's a question asked. You are responding. And that's how it goes on and on. And you learn about simple things like thanks, I agree. When you're agreeing to somebody's opinion, it means you're acknowledging the fact. Okay, so this is a general communication. I'm just showing you how it appears, and then I will tell you the benefit of why it is like this. Yeah. So this is how it appears. There are screens, there are faces, and you will also see something else coming up, which I'm waiting for a while. There's a lot many listening activities here. See, you see a red. Yeah.
I'm happy to be here.
Audio is available. Are you able to listen to the audio, Samarth? Okay. See, I'm stopping it over here. What you see here, the title are used with the names generally. They are Mr. for men, Miss for women, or Mrs. also. So now, simple words. This particular box which is appearing in front of us, which shows us two suggestions, how and where to use Mr., where to use Miss. M-S dot is, how do we pronounce that? We pronounce it as Miss. Then there is Mrs., very common. We all know where to use Mrs. So in work environment, we generally use the word M-S dot, which is Miss, pronounce it as Miss, not Miss. There is no S sound, there's Z sound, Z sound. So little things like that, you learn very specifically. This box is called as a caution note. It is telling you that in a given situation, how can you respond better? The audios that you see, this is an audio. What is it telling you? There are many things that we learn from audio, such as, what is the pronunciation of certain words? What is the voice modulation? What is the tone of the person? To whom the person is talking? How gently the message is given? How harshly the message is given? So there are ways when I say you like, please come here, please come here. This is a polite way. I say, please come here. This is very hard. I can't speak like that. So, you know, words are same, but how do we speak them makes a difference. So such audios will help you to be better speaker. Be thoughtful of what you are speaking. Second thing is your listening skill. In the work environment today, when I am able to share this with you, because we are working, your teachers are working, everybody's working. Listening skill is not a gift given to everybody. Listening skill is really hard to find. When you listen to such audios, they are helping you to listen thoroughly so that you could respond well. So, you know, when you're able to respond well, the person feels that you are listening. And like today, I must salute you, the kind of listeners you are, because the way you were responding to the questions that were asked to you shows you are a very good listener. So listening skill is one of the very important skill of 21st century, which the job interviewers are looking in the people. So start working in your listening skill right from your college level. Now, there are other features of this app also, which I would love to show you. And for that, this is the feature thing. What else? Why should I download this app? Even this app is for free. Why should I download it? What is the benefit that I will get it? So, you know, time is money today. Even if we are not spending anything, we are not spending any money, but we are spending time. Time is very precious. So the product should really help you. And how this product is helping you is because of the so many features which we discussed and which we are discussing now. The first thing is the content has images, which makes the content really exciting. If I ask you that you are given an option to read a book which is completely black and white, and there's a book which has good pictorial representations, there's a good photograph, there's a glossy picture, what would you like to read? So definitely, if this question is one-on-one, I am sure most of us would have gone for something which is more attractive to our eyes. We generally say that don't judge the book by its cover, but you know, generally things are judged by its cover, how it looks to me. The app seems to be really exciting because it has amazing pictures. Audios, we just discussed the benefit of audio. Starting from pronunciation, grammar, vocabulary, to voice modulation, different tones of expressing the message, being a good listener, many benefits of audio. Then the voice recording feature. You would also get the opportunity to record your voice in this app, which means you would record, you would put on your phone like this and you would record your voice. Hey, I'm Richard Batla, I'm speaking to the students, the best girls in this world today. I have recorded. Now I'm listening it back. Okay, let me listen to my voice. Hey, this is Richa Batla talking to the best girls of today or best youth of today, which I just shared. I am able to learn how did I speak? Was my tone fine? Was I making some grammatical errors? Could it be a little more better? So I am going back to my audio and listening to those things. So that means this is called as reflective learning. I am reflecting on my mistakes, or not even mistakes. It is not required that every time you have to do mistake to reflect. But there is always a scope to be perfect. There's always a scope to be better. So this reflective learning of listening to your own audios will help you to be better next time. And this feature is very much available on WhatsApp also. How many of you use the voice recording feature of WhatsApp? Let me see the responses. So this is a quick question. I just want to see my audience is up or sleeping. So now I'm asking you a question that do you use the voice recording feature on your WhatsApp? Yes or no? Your answers can come as yes or no. And for that, I would request Samar to see whether the responses are coming up. Samar, do we see some responses coming up?
Yes, they are. It's a mixture of both yes and no.
Great. So there's a mixture and plus point is the response is coming up. More than the answer, I am glad that people are awake and they are listening to the suggestions to be an effective communicator. So that's right. This is absolutely right that listening is important. And first of all, there could be mix of responses. So the reason why I asked you about the voice note feature is just to reflect. So once we speak on WhatsApp, many of us do have a tendency to listen to our messages, what we have shared. If I have to share a message, I'm in a hurry, I have to share it with somebody, like suppose today I was getting late from my office and I had to do parallelly some other thing. I told someone I would be a little late. I was very quick. So I will look back, what did I speak, whether it was right, whether the information was given or not in a correct manner. So such kind of learning is called as a reflective learning, which you can do as many times you want in the app feature. The second important thing about the app is it's more like a conversation. You would never feel that you are studying. It is more like you're talking to Richa today, like the way we are talking today. When you would do this app activity, you would feel that you're talking to Richa again, or you're talking to your best friend who is helping you to learn, who is helping you to be a better communicator. So you would never feel that you are studying. Like the way we spend time on Instagram or WhatsApp or Facebook, and we never realize how much time we have spent on just social media. This is your personal media. This is your personal friend who would really help you to be a better communicator if you just spend 15 minutes a day. Learning and practice. You learn through topics and you practice well through different test papers. Then there are test papers in a way, not very strict test papers. It's just a communication again. Okay, I'm giving you a situation. How would you respond in that situation? And there is a short burst of learning, which we call as caution notes. Caution notes is what? When you are writing any answer and there is a better way of responding. So on its own, a caution note will pop up like the way it popped up in the previous slide when we were discussing that, hey, instead of writing this answer, the better way of responding is this. And the third last feature is the chatbot style. The messages are popping up on its own. You were given a choice that out of four options, which option would you choose? So it's a very friendly way of learning and anybody can learn from this app. So it's not like, you know, you have to reach a certain level. It's good for everybody because there are three levels in this app. Now, these are the topics, like what all topics are covered in the app. We said that 75 units are covered in the business English and 75 are covered in general English. I am reading few of the topics for you, like your career graph. How is it going? Talking about profits in an organization, you are asked that, okay, you want to do a session for students? Calculate the profit and loss. What is the benefit to the company? What is the loss to the company? So, you know, whenever, whatever work we choose tomorrow, whether you be in banking, you be insurance, you be a teacher, you be a lawyer, any profession that you would choose, every profession requires ROI, which means return on investment. Today, if you are investing time, today you are investing your time. You 500 plus people are investing your time. We as Cambridge are investing our time. The college authorities are investing our time. So we want to see the return on investment. For us, investment is what? If you are really able to work 15 minutes a day in your communication skill, this is our return. We would be very happy. So this is the way you will be learning on the topics that will relate to your day-to-day life, that would relate to your day-to-day future career prospect. And then we have general English topics as well. Like You are meeting a friend, you are meeting a doctor, you are going to some beautiful place, you want to do some shopping, you are going in some hotel, you want to prepare for your job interview, you want to dress well, and you are finding out how to dress well. There are a few tips on that as well. So in total, there are 75 topics of general English also. We have told you that how and from where you can download the app. So already the path is given to you. If those who have missed to take that or would miss, your friends who are not in the session today, your cousins, your relatives, and it could be even mom, dad, brother, sister, everything. Communication is something which is a need of the hour for everybody. Today I learn my improve my communication on a daily basis. So there is no end to communication. Feel free to share about this app with anybody. Try to share and grow together. When we have the spirit of sharing and caring, not only the other person improve, but we actually grow to a larger extent. So if you miss out to share the link, which is given on the chat box, you can also tell them to download from Play Store directly by writing Cambridge Communication App. But the important thing is to do our part, that is to share. So I hope that you like the session that I tried sharing with you about communication app, how it is going to benefit you all. And thank you for listening. Now we can also have few questions. If someone, can we have few questions, like around 5 or 7 questions in total for 5-7 minutes?
Yes, we have received a lot of questions.
Okay,
so Richard, mostly,
one just thing, if you could tell about feedback, how to give the feedback on the app, so that these participants get the certificates.
Yes, I got it. Yeah. So now, two important pieces of information which my friends have just now told me. One is the feedback of app. Students, you know that anything has a scope of being better. I, as Richa, has a scope to be better. You, as an individual, has a scope to be better. And we can be better when we are given good feedback and right feedback. This app is trying to help the audience to be effective communicator. So this app is having a feedback form also. So once you will download the app, you would see to the left side of the app or to the right side of the app, there is a hamburger menu sign. Now, what is this hamburger menu? This is a new business term that I have learned recently and I would love to share with you. You would see three horizontal lines. So this is called as hamburger menu. When you would click on that hamburger menu, you would see number of options given to you. There is an option of sharing a link with a friend also, and there's an option of feedback also. To share with your friend, share a link with your friend, any WhatsApp friend, anybody. And to give a feedback, go to the feedback column. Your feedback would really help us to make this product even better for you, to come up with things that you really want from our side, from Cambridge being the oldest in the research space. We are 832 years plus old when it comes to improving the research space or giving the best to the people. We are UK-based university, Cambridge University, and we are a unit of Cambridge University known as Cambridge University Press India. So our major work is spent on the research area. Please give your important feedback. It will be for you. Now, another is the feedback. Your important feedback about the session would help us bring more such sessions for you. To give the feedback about the session, Samarth has shared the link with you. By Cambridge team has shared the link with you, which you can see, I can also see right in front of my screen. Please copy paste this link somewhere and go to the feedback form and share the feedback. Like, did you like the session or whatever you would like to share on this part? And we would definitely try to bring more such things for you. Also, those who have attended the session would be getting a certificate. You would be receiving the certificate once you would be filling up the feedback form. Feedback not of the app, but of this link or the link which is provided to you. So once you fill up the feedback, you would be getting a certificate on your email ID. So I hope I have given you all the instructions. And now we have another 5-7 minutes to take few questions that we have already received in Q&A section. I would be reading it out and I'll be sharing the answers with you the best I can. Any important messages, Samarth and Vineet, that is to be shared?
Thank you, Richa. As of now, this is it. And we can take the Q&A. And the question which has repeated number of times is that how do we improve our communication skill?
Yeah. So, dear students, as I can also see, there are so many questions. So, one says that what if no one around us speak in English? This is a very important thing. This is something which most of us struggle. Like, I come from a city and I am sharing my personal journey also so that we relate well. I also come from a city, which is a very small city. Not everybody knows in the country where I come from. So in that city, in that school, there was not much exposure to English. We didn't find our teachers speaking in English. We couldn't see our friends speaking in English. And I wanted to learn English. And there are people, just maybe a question, Poochha, I'm so sure that you also want to learn English. That is the reason you have asked me. So now when it comes to speaking in English and there is no environment, what you should do? You should lead it. You be the leader. You be the initiator. You have to create your own environment. You have to be that first and one student who stands tall and say to everybody in the class that let us all try speaking in English. Let us all just try. Because, you know, once you try, then only you improve. What is important is to start. So here I would suggest to all of you, those who don't get the environment to speak in English, those who see nobody around us speak in English, you be the first one. You have to lead. Be it right, be it wrong, doesn't matter. Now, how to start? The question is, I really want to start, but I myself don't know. I want to speak in English, but I myself struggle. I don't know how to improve. Now there, you have to practice. How do you practice? By thinking. In our day, we see so many thoughts coming up in our mind. There would be a thought, like for example, what are the thoughts that we would have faced? Before the session, there was a thought, okay, I have to start a session. And I'm speaking this in Hindi so that you understand what I try to say. Mujhe ye session attend karna hai, 11 baje mera session ho sakta hai. Okay, Preeti ma'am ne koi link share kiya tha, hamare kisi teacher ne link share kiya tha. Mera laptop charge hai kya? Mera phone charge hai kya? Please mujhe is time disturb mat karna mom dad. Mera koi session hai. What is this? These are all communication with me, with my own self and my surrounding. So when I start talking to myself in English, how it could be? Oops, I have a session at 11. Oops, my laptop is charged or not. Okay, I would be using my phone today. No phone calls for the session. Mom, dad, please, please take care. Nobody should disturb me. And my brother should not come into my room when I take the session. All this interaction that I am having with myself in my mind, I am trying to start in English. I was talking about the environment. How do I create the environment? How do I see the environment? See, nobody is entering in your mind to create environment. There are not 10 people sitting in your mind who talks to you, hey, Hindi mein baat karte hai. You are the one. You are the one who are talking to you, who is talking to your own self. So why not to think in English? So the first way to begin speaking in English is to think in English. When you think in English, your ideas would start expressing in English. Be it a broken English, be it a wrong English, doesn't matter. This is how you learn. So I hope this answers the question of the people who believe that I don't have an environment to speak in English. Thinking in English, lead in English, and you will soon develop your own environment. Now, there is a second question. While I speak, I feel nervous. I don't know why. So, dear students, being nervous is with everybody. You are not only that child, and I must say, you please don't mind if I share your name here, because you know there are guts to come out with the problem. Problem is faced by 500 plus people today. That is the reason we all are in the session. Otherwise, we wouldn't have attended the session if we feel that we are perfect. We have problems. But there are very few people who have guts to speak about their problems. So Komal has shared that she feels nervous. And Komal, I must share, Richa equally feels nervous too. So you are not that special person who is only feeling nervousness when it comes to speaking to people. So your nervousness can only break when you do what is creating you that nervousness in the environment. That means if speaking to your teacher is nervousness for you, go and speak to your teacher. speaking to the principal is a nervousness for you, go and speak to the principal. If speaking on stage is a problem for you, if participating in debate is a problem for you, coming on stage and sharing anything is a problem for you, do it. So where is the solution of breaking your fear or nervousness is to do it. I had my own nervousness. I remember when I was on stage, my legs were shivering like anything when I tried for the first time. My hand was shivering, my legs were shivering, but this is how we all start. Imagine if I wouldn't have started, God wouldn't have given me this great opportunity to interact with such a beautiful audience today. So what is the solution? To start, not to worry. When you do things what you are nervous of, it will all break down. This is a stepping stone to your growth. So now I hope, Komal, you get the answer. And it is not only Komal's question. This is the question of millions of people with whom we interact on a daily basis who feel that I'm nervous. Solution to break any nervous is to do that thing, is to do which creates nervousness. And then there is a question, how to be a good speaker. So we discussed on various steps today. We spoke about reading books. We spoke about watching videos. We spoke about talking in English. So every little thing that we do, and the app, which is very important. Why do I say that? Because I have myself learned a lot from that app, and I'm still using it because it's absolutely free. So, you know, the best thing is how to improve your English is to practice all these things. As of today, I might have shared with you all those things that you already know. You would say, okay, session was interesting, but Richard, ma'am, just told everything that I was already knowing. What's new here? So dear students, what you know, what's new? The new would be when you would practice. So most of the time we have a lot of information given to us by everybody. Where do we lack? We lack on practice. We lack on consistency. So now do this, that today, whatever you have learned from the session, practice it and be consistent. Spend around 30 days as a meditation, that every day 15 minutes in the most relaxing way. Sometimes you would feel like reading a book. Sometimes you would feel like going through an app and learning through app. Sometimes you would like talking to people. If you are wanting variety in your activity to be a better speaker, do it. But without doing it, just listening to the tips will not help. You have to practice and you have to be consistent. This is the two things that I believe have helped me. So now we see more questions, and I would be taking just two more questions now, and then we would be wrapping up the session. I want to communicate in English, but the people around me doesn't speak. So I have already shared that if you don't have an environment, create one environment and start with the idea. And how to improve our communication skills, we discussed on the topic very much, that what are the various ways. So more than the ways, it is an approach. If there is one child in the audience who feel, okay, I will just read books, then be consistent. One would say, okay, this app seems interesting, I will just follow this app. Be consistent. It's not like one day downloaded, 2 days practice, third day gone. I want a genuine feedback from you, dear audience. I just don't want free feedback for the namesake. Because ma'am has said that, we will do. I would love that you are really practicing and giving a genuine feedback, because this will help us to make better things for you. And then I want to communicate. So basically the questions are repeating. Anything which is new coming up, which you can see, Vineet or Samarth, you please share it with me. Otherwise we can end it. Okay, so yeah, we got a good question. Will effective communication help us to save our jobs from AI, artificial intelligence? It's a very technical question. It's a very smart question. It seems that the listener knows about AI and stuff, which is very good. So dear audience, you know, how much technology could pace up? How much technology could improve in today's time? The communication will never go. It will never fade. Today, organizations in the time of pandemic look forward for people who are multitaskers, people who could do couple of jobs. They are good in their work, but they are also good in other tasks as well. So when it is a time when everybody wants to save cost, get the best from the people, it cannot happen in silence. You cannot be mum and get the things done. You have to speak. You have to be a smart speaker. Your listening, your comprehension skill, your critical thinking, your effective communication. These are the C's of, you know, 21st century. We say the C's of 21st century, which includes so many things. Curiosity to learn, be creative, be a good communicator, be a collaborator. So all those things are important. And all these things comes out where? It comes on the language we speak. How can you be creative in sharing your ideas when you don't speak? So that means that communication cannot go out from any of the other C we talk about, be it curiosity, collaboration, or any other aspect. So when you talk about that technology is growing, will effective communication help? It is the mantra to succeed and lead. Don't forget that whatever the world will be tomorrow, communication will always be important, always. So I think we are done with the session. So now, respecting the time that we have taken from you, respecting the time that we decided for the session, so I would like to say a big thank you for being effective listeners in the session. I hope you would be downloading the app and utilize its benefit to the maximum. We are also sharing the email ID with you where you can write your questions related to communication skills if those questions were not taken today in the session because of the paucity of time. And I would request Samarth to please mention the email address where they can write the questions. And it would help them. That is elt.india@cambridge.org. Samarth?
Yes, it is.
Great. So elt.india@cambridge.org is our email ID where we would love to have questions from you girls. Please feel free to write to us on anything that you want to share. And we would love to give you a solution of your queries. Beside this, it was lovely interacting. Thank you for all your support. Thank you, Preeti ma'am, Nisha ma'am, for organizing the event for us. It was wonderful talking to girls, and especially the numbers were really amazing. Still, we have 460 participants in the session. And now I would request Preeti ma'am to please take over.
Thank you, Richa. Indeed, I'm really happy today to see the response of my girls. A big thank you to you girls. Before saying the formal thank you, I would request my girls to please fill your name and email addresses properly because many of the emails are being bounced. Please fill your name and your email address properly so that you can get the certificate. I'm really, really, really happy to see the response of my girls today.
So am I. Really great.
I feel so privileged to propose a vote of thanks today. And it is indeed in the history of this college that the number of participants was so much. It was about 600 at some time. And I'm really happy and definitely we'll organize more of webinars. And we have trained 3,000 participants till now with the Cambridge. You know? And I would like thanks Cambridge University Press for collaborating with us. It was indeed initiative of Richa and Vineet to organize this webinar. Thank you both. Thank you, Vineet. Thank you, Richa. I would like to thank Principal Madam Professor Nisha Agarwal for granting permission to organize this webinar on communication skills. Her positivity and insight has given a new height to this webinar. I also extend thanks from my side to the Cambridge University Press for again joining us. My sincere thanks to Richa, to you especially, for such a nice presentation and introducing the communication app to the girls and taking the question answers and giving us so many suggestions. Thank you, Richa. Thank you once again. I would express my sincere thanks to the faculty member of my college because they have helped me a lot to ask the students to join this webinar. It is in fact their hard work that so many students have joined this webinar. An event of this dimension cannot happen overnight. It requires meticulous planning and execution and eye on every detail. I would thank the team members of Cambridge University Press, especially Samarth, who is always in touch with us, and my colleagues for organizing this webinar. I would like to thank all the participants, especially to the BA students of my college who have blessed us with their presence. Last but not the least, a big thank you to each and everyone who has contributed in one or the other way to make this webinar successful. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thanks a lot. Yeah.
Okay, we are